Welcome to How It Works, a video series from LawSites and LawNext, in which you get to see hands-on demonstrations of legal tech products directly from their developers. Today's episode, we're going to get a demonstration of CaseReview from Mindset Integrated, a tool designed to simplify case file management and enable legal professionals to organize, share, and track important case file notes. Joining us to tell us about it and show us how it works are Jason Kerkmans, the founder and executive vice president, and Rebecca Shore, vice president of clinical and legal operations. Jason and Rebecca, welcome to the show.
Thanks. Glad to be here.
So before we get into a demonstration, Jason, why don't you give us a little bit of a background on the company and on the product that we're going to be talking about today?
Yeah. Mindset was created in 2013. We were founded inside of a neuroscience research laboratory. What we primarily do is integration of brain investigations for legal cases. So both Rebecca and I are attorneys, and other legal teams will bring us on to help with advanced imaging, admissibility of scientific evidence, and coordinating expert review of both the data and the case file to be prepared for testimony and trial. We do that across criminal and civil cases, and as you can imagine, in doing that, we would get a lot of medical records and education records, employment records, anything in the client's pre-existing history. Those would get dumped on us in varying levels of completeness or review, and working with experts that are charging $750 to $1,250 an hour for their time got to be really expensive to have them flip through a lot of extraneous records. And so we, about 2017, started developing a software tool to help us manage that. We call it CaseReview. We've been using it successfully for 8 years internally, and just now have decided that it's been so efficient for our practice that it'd be a good time to let other people see if it works for them with the inclusion of AI features and a full built-in security network so that it can be used externally. We're at the point to release it and let others give it a run.
So you've decided you've got something pretty good. You ought to share it with others and make it available to them.
It's worked well for us so far.
All right, good. Let's not waste any further time on talking about it. I think people want to see what you've got here. So let's just jump into a screen share. I think, Rebecca, you're going to take it away and show us how it works, right?
Yes. I'm going to start by jumping into one of our test cases here. And I'm going to go and show you where we put all of the documents that you receive. So this is what's called sources. And within sources, you can add a source. It will OCR it, basically give you some high-level summary from our AI feature. If you go in, you can see you can actually get summaries of it, edit it, remove it if you don't find it necessary, but it'll be in there as part of the AI. And from the sources, you basically take that information and you can create what are called events. So before I move on to events, do you have any questions about the sources?
Just, I don't think you said this at the beginning, but I assume this is a cloud-based software application or not an on-premises application.
Yes. So from your sources, you create what are called events. If you go up to events, basically you choose your source. It'll populate next to a side-by-side, create a title, author, date, description. You can tag an event, starting page, ending page. You can highlight it if you would like, and then include it in the timeline. As I said, the AI feature will do this for you, and you can go through and have it that populate your events, but you can also do it manually. From there, it's going to pull up your event here. As you can see, it'll show you the summary. You have your case tags, so this is potentially, or this is tagged for medical records and imaging records, and then you can see your page numbers, and from there you can directly hyperlink into the document, and it'll highlight the pages that you've selected there.
I wonder if you could just explain a little bit more when you said that you can have AI populate some of that information. How does that work, or how would that work?
So the AI pulls out down here on the sources, and it'll pull out events for you. And so basically, it's doing what you would manually do. And so it's populated a title, a date, a summary, and the page This one says unknown author, so it didn't have an author to attribute it to. And then if you want to add that to the events, you can edit it here, you can remove it, or you can publish these to the case events.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So. Thanks.
A lot of attorneys are probably familiar with, especially on the medical record side, the medical chronologies that a nurse or even have their paralegals prepare. And while those are always helpful for us when we would get them, they weren't connected back to the source material in a way that was efficient. And so having the way we originally used this was creating these events ourselves, like a chronology, but then having it all interactive. Adding the AI feature now allows for the speed of AI to create those events, but then still remaining interactive and connected to the source material so that you're not relying on AI for your summary.
So now you have the chronology, you have it tagged, you have it linked back to the source material. It just makes it all much more accessible.
All right. As I said, the events all will link to the timeline as long as you have that selected. You can opt to keep them off of the timeline. They will all populate right here. You have the ability to click into any one of them right here on the timeline, and it'll show you basically the summary and the tags. You can sort. So if you only want to see imaging records, you can highlight that tag. It'll only pull up the imaging on the timeline. Same for the events. If you select the tag, it'll only pull those up, and you can download just those events. But the timeline can also be printed, and you can go and download the timeline as well. So if you go there, it'll print the timeline. You can select years, you can select weeks, start date, end date, you filter by, and then it will populate your timeline there. Do you have any questions about the timeline?
I don't think so on that, but actually, I think I meant to ask a little bit earlier, just in terms of the uploading documents into the system in the first place, what kinds of documents are accepted? What kinds of documents can be loaded into this? Does it matter? Is it Word, PDF?
Yeah, it's currently not limited. The video files do take a bit longer to mm-hmm. upload, as you'll see on any platform, so you just have to kind of be patient with those. But PDFs, Word docs, it's probably most useful with PDFs, in my opinion, but you can upload any file source.
All right.
Audio files and video files, pictures.
Yeah. Next, I will show you the tags that we've talked about. You have the ability to add or edit custom tags. You can do this within each case, but you can also do it across your platform. So if you want to change these default tags, you can go to the main page and actually add and edit what populates for every case across your platform. If you only want to change what you're seeing custom tags wise on your actual case page, you can go in and do it here. You can change if you have a witness that is going to be in this case and you want to say Dr. X, you can put here, add their name, come down here, confirm, and it'll populate within the tags there. And then when you go to add and edit events, you can select these tags. And then, as I said, you can sort by the tags. If you have two tags you want to sort, you can select two of them. So you just have a lot of variability and options when it comes to selecting via the tags.
So it's just a matter of picking an icon, giving it the label you want, and then that's it, right?
Yep. Yeah.
So in litigation, some attorneys will use it to prepare for a deposition by tagging everything that they want or that is relevant to Dr. Smith, who's the plaintiff's expert, and then they can create a timeline and an event table keyed toward that deposition.
I like the icons. A lot of people tend to use Word tags these days, and I think the icons are nice because they kind of let you visually quickly see what it is and what it's about.
Yeah, and if you hover over them, you can get your words, but I like the visualization too, because once you get used to them, you just know which ones are which and you can see them visually.
Yeah.
Any other questions on tags?
No, it looks pretty straightforward.
Then I'm going to come down to research documents. Within our platform, you have research documents, and you have the ability to add research specifically to the actual case. So similar to tags, you can add them to a repository of research documents that remains across your platform, which would be accessible to every case and every user that has access to the research documents. Otherwise, you can add specific ones into the case itself here. And from there, you can add the research documents, which you can also add case law. It'll populate a citation, so Blue Book or APA, and you can switch here between the two. You can download your research. And as I said, you can link from the actual main research repository to the cases as well. So if there's a case that comes up repeatedly across all of your cases, you can put it in your main repository, and then you can link it to all the cases where it's relevant, and it'll show up here.
And we see the examples that you have there tend to be medical research articles. Is that generally how it's used, or can it be research into other areas or even legal research or that kind of
thing? Yeah, it can be research in any area. We typically use it for medical or that type of research, but I've used it for case law as well. So you can add in a title, a description, choose a file, perform text extraction, and then add in the information for the citation. So there's really no limitation on what you're using for research there. It can come from basically any sort of source.
Because you share the library or you maintain a library for your firm that's agnostic to the individual cases, you can organize it by topic and then attach those to each individual case as they develop. So if you have a library of case law and scientific research related to carbon monoxide poisoning, and you get a new carbon monoxide poisoning case, and when you establish that case, you can immediately link that folder of research to it so that you're not having to go back and look across different platforms to find the information.
Mm-hmm. I see the search bar up there. Are you searching across just the metadata, or is that a full text search?
You can search through individually here, but we do also have a search feature up here where you can search through everything. So you can select a case, you can select a source, you can select research documents, and then you can search across the board on the platform.
Okay. All right. I guess just to amplify a little bit, Jason, I think at the outset, you touched on the security of this, but I know that for any legal professionals using a system like this, that's something they always want to know about. So could you just talk a little bit more about that?
Yeah, it's built on an AWS platform, and we've built in the 2FA security to it. There's different user levels at which you can create users within your firm or experts that you've brought on to work on a case. So a administrator has access to everything and can add users. There's an editor who can work on individual cases and add and remove information from those. And then there's a reviewer level, which we find helpful with outside experts because they're able to see everything and not change it or remove anything accidentally. The entire platform is encrypted. Obviously, there's being cloud-based, there's the added level of security for comfort using it.
And just for any law firm watching this right now that might be interested in knowing how they get started on it, how do they get started on it? Is it just simply going to a website and signing up, or is there some setup involved, or what's involved there?
Yeah, we've intentionally kept it minimal and tried to create a platform for easy use as opposed to trying to overhaul your entire online software platform for you. The easiest way is to go to our website, which is mindsetintegrated.com. We can then walk you through a demo in more detail where we can show you trials of the software so you can start to see how it works. And if it fits well with how your currently managing your cases, then we're ready to move forward from there. I should add also that each individual client's site is customized to them, so they have their own unique URL for it, and they can customize with logos and color changes and everything as well.
Oh, great. Okay. All right. Was there anything else you wanted to mention before we wrap up?
I think that's it.
All right. Jason, Rebecca, thanks so much for coming on the show and telling us about CaseReview today. I appreciate it.
Yeah. Thank you for your time. Thank you.
That's it for this episode of How It Works. Thanks for watching. You can find the full series on YouTube. Just search for How It Works there. We're also on directory.lawnext.com under the Resources tab. This is Bob Ambrosi. Thanks for watching.